Michelle's birthday ruined after Trump drops nasty surprise right on Obama's doorstep. It seems Michelle Obama has been keeping her distance from Barack for several months, as she jet sets all over the country, solo. Recently, Michelle was caught partying with Malia in Miami, trying to forget the shocking allegations coming out about Barack's tenure as president. Now, her birthday is ruined after President Donald Trump dropped a nasty surprise right on the Obama's doorstep, something she never saw coming. The last part of January is going to be explosive as certain shoes start to drop, one by one, exposing Barack Hussein Obama as the biggest traitor to America. Poor Michelle Obama was last seen partying in Miami with daughter Malia, and it looked like she had not a care in the world. That all changed in an instant after President Donald Trump dropped a lawsuit on the beleaguered opposition research firm, Fusion GPS. It was as if Trump had dropped that nasty surprise right on the Obama's doorstep, and it was just in time for Michelle's birthday on January 17. You may be wondering what Fusion GPS has to do with Barack Obama. Fusion GPS is the bogus opposition research firm hired by Hillary Clinton in April 2016 to dig up dirt on then-candidate Donald Trump. The problem for Barack is that there is clear evidence that his DOJ and FBI paid and colluded with Fusion GPS to set up Trump to lose the election and, after he won, to then get him impeached, and Barack as president sanctioned it. In the infamous Russian dossier that came from Fusion GPS, it mentions Trump's attorney Michael Cohen. It says Michael Cohen traveled to Prague and met with Kremlin bad guys. This is in the dossier and is part of the proof special counsel Robert Mueller is using to use to say Trump colluded with the Russians. Except, where did this intelligence, saying that Michael Cohen traveled to Prague and met with Kremlin bad guys, come from? That's where Barack is in trouble, big time. What if Obama was told the FBI was spying on Michael Cohen in Prague? What if the entire thing can be proven to be a lie and that Obama knew and sanctioned the FBI spying on an American citizen, unmasking an American citizen, and then it turns out it is all based on lies to set Trump up? Well, that's exactly what happened. The FBI was running all names of anyone associated with Trump through the National Security Administration's database, FISA 702 searches, and they were doing it without warrants. Hoping to catch a Trump associate breaking the law, they ran the name Michael Cohen. We know that FBI contractors, perhaps fusion entities, used unlawful FBI FISA 702 searches to gain information that was passed on to Fusion GPS and Nellie Orr, wife of DOJ attorney Bruce Orr, etc. We also know the story of Michael Cohen traveling to Prague is inside the Steele dossier, and we know the story is false, it was the wrong Michael Cohen, reports the conservative Treehouse. Now, Michael Cohen is suing Fusion GPS. Cohen can prove without a doubt that he has never traveled to Prague, and secondly, he was in the US on the dates he was supposedly in Prague. So, why did Barack Obama, as president, allow the FBI to spy on Cohen? Politico reports, the Fusion GPS lawsuit, which was filed at a federal court level, seeks $100 million in damages. A separate amount in damages for the BuzzFeed lawsuit, which was filed at the state court level, will be determined at trial, according to court documents obtained by Politico. The report adds, the dossier claims that Cohen met with Russian operatives somewhere in Europe, including Prague, to attend a meeting to clean up the mess created by public disclosures of other Trump associates' reported ties to Russia. Cohen has denied that a Prague meeting occurred, saying that he has never been to the Czech Republic. The deep state idiots found a Michael Cohen going to Prague, except they got the wrong Michael Cohen. Enough is enough of the #fake #Russian dossier, Cohen tweeted Tuesday. Just filed a defamation action against at BuzzFeed News for publishing the lie-filled document on at BOTUS at Real Donald Trump and Me. Radio host and attorney Mark Levin broke it down, saying, if a FISA warrant, searches, was issued against a candidate or anyone in Trump world, or an individual who is said to work for Trump and so forth, you have to believe and know that it was in the presidential daily briefings. If Trump is colluding with the Russians, which is a damnable lie, but nevertheless, you have to believe it was in the presidential daily briefings. Obama was receiving information on that. Levin screams, "Where are these briefings? I know I'm supposed to go along and say shithole, 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 that's this week's cover-up. Last week it was mentally ill, mentally ill, mentally ill, well I'm not buying it." Apparently, neither is Michelle Obama. With that lawsuit, the question will be who sanctioned the unmasking and spying on an American citizen, based solely on lies? So, Mrs. Barack Obama is keeping her distance from her husband. In fact, he didn't even wish her a happy birthday on Twitter like he usually does. Lies have a way of catching up to you, especially lies that are written down in the presidential daily briefings. The past PDB are all on record in the White House. Trump's got all the ammunition he needs, so stay tuned as he systematically dismantles Barack Obama and his deep state rats. It really is a horrible birthday for poor Michelle.